Is it possible for a soul to have multiple incarnations at the same time?
It is, yes. Okay, let's say this. We had Roger understand. As it speaks through us, we are Wilhelm, yes. But it has shifted throughout time. And in 2012, the reason it was so different for him, because there was, as it explained to him, a walk-in personality, so to speak, that brought in new information. And many people can have that. He has a different way of receiving this. As we said, he resisted it for so long, but now it's making sense, which will happen for all of you at some point. You move along in your evolutionary path towards this greater awareness until you're no longer to no longer need this particular incarnation. The thing that we wanted you to all understand is that you're in physical form for a limited amount of time. You all know that. And you just decide how pleasurable you're going to make it during that time that you're here. But you're here now, all of you, anyone who would hear this, you're here to make a great contribution, because your world has never moved through this. And it all depends the way that it turns out. It's going to turn out well, but the experience that you will have will depend on how each of you decide to use your lives to move through this. And you can only do it in this moment.
So the shift that is happening now has never happened in the history of humanity as
no.
far back as it goes.
No, it's not. Nothing has happened. No, this is brand new. And that's what we wanted you to understand. Now, you've had similar periods where you've moved through changes in your world. You can go back and see them. And we've taken Roger back through many of them. If this is why we use the dates. And when we talk about the Mayan calendar, yes, that was another civilization. And they did have this information that they brought through. And then they said, okay, now we're going to let you take over. And that's what happened in 2012. So it's always a continuation of consciousness. And so you're moving through this particular period for each of you, to allow each of you who are here and decided to be here. Your age doesn't matter, by the way. Doesn't matter how old you are, how young, you're still doing the same thing, because your soul decided that this time for your incarnation was going to be helpful in your evolutionary journey when you decide to love who you are. And so that's what your world is attempting to do in this shift. And it's never occurred before, which is why it's been so chaotic, which is why we gave Roger this information, because we wanted more of you to understand, because the more of you understand, you will make this transition much better.
What is the role of meditation and prayer in our spiritual practice?
It gets you out of your head. It gets you to shut up. It gets you to listen a little bit more. You all have consciousness, and you know this. And some people say, well, no, I don't hear anything. I don't know what's going on. That's not possible. When you close your mouth and you're sitting, you have thoughts. They're always there. The difficulty that you have is that you're only listening to the ones that destroy you sometimes, that make you feel worse, less than what you are. That's when you're in your conscious state, you see. So when you move yourself into this state of stillness, of meditation, you hear something completely different. When we are working with Roger, when he's in this state, he has no trouble. He has no problems. Everything is wonderful. He feels the light and love of everything. And then when we let go of him and he comes back into his normal life, he has to deal with all the stuff that you're all doing. But you have those periods where you let go of that. And that is why meditation and prayer, when you're doing prayer, it's the same thing. You just all use different terms. But when you're praying for something, you're using what we call focused attention. And you can only do that in your moment and now. And you can only do that when you decide to listen and be quiet, you see. But when you start to find the thoughts that you want to have and the thoughts that you want to place into your world, into your life, and that is what manifests your world. You create your life, your world and your life through your energetic thoughts. And so when you're using the ones that you want, you're creating a very different experience. And we gave you a process called, we've given you many, but we gave you one: focused attention. With focused attention, you can create anything.
What is the path to enlightenment or self-realization?
It's a process of moving through. It's a step-by-step process. And we've given you this too. It's a progression. It means that you move through your limited thinking. It's a daily thing. That's why we advise you to do it daily. It's a daily thing. And then each time you move through that, you're in a different existence. You have moved to a higher level of understanding. You all come into the world with these blockages, with these barriers. And again, we want you to understand that during this time, you've carried in more of the generational, more of the ancestral limitations. That's why it's everybody's jockeying for their position, so to speak, to feel a sense of safety. However, you're meant to let go of that. And so when you decide to say, okay, I'm having this terrible thought about myself, I'm having this terrible thought about someone else, that's not what I want to put into the world. So I'm going to use this moment in this moment, because that's where my power is, and I'm going to change that thought. And each time you do that, this magical thing happens. You start to feel better. Oh, well, today I was like kind of down on myself. Today I'm, now the next day I'm better. And then I'll keep getting better. But you're never going to stay there, because there's going to be something else that comes up that's going to kind of hit you a little bit. And then you say, okay, this is another opportunity for me to move through some limited thought I've had about myself or the world or some other person, and go to the higher state of understanding and bring in a new light and love in my life. So I can bring that to the world. That's what you're each doing.
To watch the full video, click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.